a regular supermarket in Mumbai. Check the shelves and you'll find things that weren't there just a few years back. Many of these exotic food items have made their way to dining tables, so much so that they're almost staples now. For Mumbai-based councillor Bela Raja, food isn't any longer about just dal, chawal and sabzi. She represents the lakhs of well-travelled urban Indians who enjoy their share of morning cereals and continental dinners.
When I was growing up as a child, the variation in the menus at home, in the food that was put on our table, used to be limited to different kinds of dal, used to be limited to different kinds of vegetables, maybe even different kinds of rotis and different kinds of rice preparations. Now, with the world opening up and with access to so many different kinds of food, we have broccoli and we have baby corn, we have mushrooms, we have bell peppers of all kinds and unlimited other things that come in and we create different cuisines.
Just look at the kind of food that has become a staple at Bela's home. Her breakfast often consists of whole wheat bread, cereals or waffles. And while lunch is mostly Indian, dinner can be anything from spaghetti to baked to Chinese. And yes, everything is cooked in olive oil. Now just which of that would you have found in India 15 years ago? But for experts, this change in consumption is all a part of India's growth story.
People are eating more food, better quality food, because they have more money.
To illustrate just how food consumption has changed in the past 15 years, take Kellogg's Corn Flakes for an example. While Indians rejected the cereal when it was launched, preferring to stick to their upma and poha, 15 years hence, the breakfast cereal market is growing at 30% a year. Research shows just how diversified food consumption patterns of Indians have become after India opened up. First up, consumption of non-seasonal fruits, vegetables, meat and poultry has gone up. People are consuming more beverages, biscuits and salted snacks, and frozen food is finding favor with Indians with an annual growth rate of 11.2%. The processed food industry is growing at 12% a year, and in fact even the consumption of staples like milk are changing, with many opting for the easy-to-store Tetra Pak varieties. And amidst all of this, surprisingly, the per capita consumption of rice and cereals has gone down. And private food retailers have been quick to cash in on these changing patterns, and now there's a mushrooming of big chains across metros with big expansion plans for the future. Entrepreneurs like Big Bazaar's Kishore Biyani are only too happy to endorse this change.
It's time for India to consume and China to consume. I think India should consume more than anybody else in the world, and that will make us a big nation.
But while everybody makes merry in this boom, one has to confess that no matter how strong the trend is, it's a drop in the ocean. For a large part of India, staples are still very much the norm and take years to change. But for a handful living in swanky metros, food and what they eat has changed, and it's this segment that the Indian food and beverage industry is increasingly focusing on.
Clearly, as dal and chawal give way to more exotic fare, a large chunk of middle-class India now spends more money than they ever did on good food, a clear reflection of the big money that's coming into the hands of Indians and their growing affluence. With camera person Vijay, Nikhil Anandar, UTVI, Mumbai.